goods, yogurt, wheat germ, cookies, and sunflower seeds.
All in that?
Try me.
Pizza, yogurt, and ice cream.
Oh, what a weird combination.
What Stevie's kidding.
Okay, well then give me Cracker Jacks, chips, and sunflower seeds.
I'm going to call mine weird.
What?
That'll be $9.75, please. Come on.
Here, just get the change.
Wow, a whole quarter, and I can finally go on that vacation. Get them here. Hot dogs, egg rolls, ice cream cone.
Anything is possible. On a summer's night, when the moon is as full as this.
Oh, please, Hank, just relax.
You're only throwing your money away.
It's not my money, it's yours.
You really want to?
Laugh if you will. But what I tell you will surely come to pass.
If anybody knows sees us, it'll look as if we don't have a date.
We don't. Since we don't, why not enjoy this? The music, the excitement.
The reason we're here is because America's favorite comedy writer is practically engaged to his TV story editor, your boss.
They're not engaged yet.
Face it, if he fell over you right now, he wouldn't remember where you are.
That's only because his nose is always in the script whenever I'm right in front of him. There they are.
That was fun, Johnny. Let's go through the House of Mirrors again.
Once is enough for me. I get woozy in there.
Me too. Better stay close, in case I trip. Peggy, come back! Don't follow him! Haven't you any pride?
Oh. Tell your future young lady, only $1.
Here. I'm listening.
Let me see. I see a young man coming into your life.
In and out, like all the rest?
He's tall, very good looking. He has red hair and a passionate nature.
And a passionate wife?
He will have, unless you don't believe in marriage.
Oh, I believe in marriage, and Santa Claus, and the Tooth Fairy, and the Easter Bunny, and thanks for the fairy tale. Poor Peggy, he doesn't even know she's alive.
Oh, Johnny, I'm so happy. Do you want a big wedding or just a simple ceremony?
What?
You asked me, darling. They'll tell you you've already forgotten.
Forgotten?
You mean you don't want to marry me?
Of course I do. Why have I got such a headache?
Take me home, darling. Then go home yourself and get a good night's rest.
I feel like I could use one.
Understanding? I heard her. She practically put the words, "Will you marry me?" in his mouth. Oh, Johnny, now it's over between us. And the sad part of it is, it never even began.
Tell your future young lady.
I'll tell you. I'm going to be an old maid. If I can't have the man I want, then I don't want any.
One. Let me see. I see a double lie.
Double lie?
I see a split personality. At least I think it's a personality.
If they're mine, both of them are miserable. Well?
The light of the moon so bright. Everything is all mixed up. I cannot read you, young lady.
Even a fortune teller won't take my money. Sure says a lot for my future.
Something strange has happened here tonight. And it wasn't caused by the rays of the full moon. Something strange is about to happen, or perhaps it already has.
Nobody home. You've got the wrong number. Bye.
Mr. Barnes, don't hang up. It's Peggy.
I don't know anyone named Peggy. Bye again.
Peggy, Miss Morgan's secretary.
Oh, sure. Why are you calling me in the middle of the night?
It's 10 o'clock a.m.
You just made that up. Wow, you did make that up. Well, I slept as if I was hit by a bulldozer.
You were.
What did you say?
I said you were expecting Miss Morgan and Mr. Thompson, the network president, at 11, remember?
Vaguely. Only vaguely.
I'm calling to tell you Mr. Thompson's plane arrived earlier from Minneapolis. We'll all make your apartment in about half an hour.
Well,
maybe sooner.
I'm in no condition for a meet. Well, okay, Polly.
Peggy. Peggy, not Polly, Mr. Burns.
Sorry, Peggy. Tell Miss Morgan I'll be full of the old zip and ready to go.
He doesn't even remember your name.
Don't rub it in.
How many dozens of times has he seen you?
I've never counted.
Seeing through you is a better way of putting it, as if you're not even there.
Oh, Mr. Barnes.
Oh, Molly, I must have dozed off again.
I can come back clean up later.
No. Glad you woke me. Important meeting here really soon. Important people, the president and all.
You better go up and start dressing.
Remind me to tell you I love you. I love you, but I can't marry you. Which reminds me, I'm engaged to marry someone else.
Oh, Mr. Barnes, that's wonderful.
Yeah, it was happened all so quickly. Maybe that's why I overslept.
Too much excitement.
Yeah, it was all so sudden. Wasn't she supposed to say that?
It's Miss Morgan now, isn't it?
That's right.
Oh, she's smart and beautiful, too. What more could any man want?
This man could use something for a headache. She is right. Denise is everything a man could want. I don't know why I got such a headache. Maybe it's that papaya juice was poison or something. I need to hurry and get ready. I wonder if I need to shave. Ah! It's true. It was poison. I'm seeing things.
Good morning. Yes, you should shave.
Maybe I'm having a nightmare.
You're wide awake in your own apartment. This is your mirror. Only my reflection is in it instead of yours.
That's the craziest.
Isn't it?
I see it, but I don't believe it. Things like this just don't happen.
It happened last night in the House of Mirrors. It wasn't my fault.
Hey, wait a minute. Let me just tab this slowly.
In case you didn't know, trick mirrors are a terrible strain on us poor reflections.
In case you didn't know, I'm about to go into shock. But before I do, let's hear the rest of this.
Your reflection and the reflection of the person I belong to were switched in the House of Mirrors.
I still don't understand. I see you, but I still understand you.
From what I understand, two reflections simply went home with the wrong people. That's all.
That's enough.
Oh, I'll get that, Mr. Barnes.
Thanks, Molly. I'll finish getting dressed.
Good morning, Molly. My darling, any coffee ready?
I just put it on, Mr. Price.
Oh, good. Where's our boy genius today?
He's up in the bathroom dressing. He doesn't look too good this morning.
Oh, really? You know, I should have his worries. Hey, buddy boy, why don't you come on out? The Star of TV show's here.
In a minute, Ed.
Did he tell you the news, Molly?
About him being engaged to be married? I think it's wonderful.
Yeah, it's just great. Came to congratulate him.
Oh, that's sweet of you, Mr. Price. I'll be leaving, Mr. Barnes. I'm through here now. Goodbye, Mr. Price. I'll be seeing you on MeTV. I just love that song and dance you did. I just closed my eyes, and I pretended you were singing just to me.
Well, Molly, you want to make that a reality?
Take a half step here, then step, kick, and turn around. Then you slide from side to side, and just run right down to the ground. The Big Apple, the Big Apple, just do the Big Apple, ride with me.
Let's do the dance together in all kinds of weather with me on your arm.
I'm blinded by all your charm. The Big Apple, the Big Apple, just do the Big Apple, rag with me. I can't begin to tell you how much it pleases me to have you at my side.
It definitely is exciting to be the one you choose tonight. It feels so strange to see him looking at me.
It's unbelievable she could pay attention to me.
There you go, now you're getting the hang of it. you go. It's nice to hold you like this, then turn right into a love.
I could stay this way all night with you as my guide.
Let's do the dance together in all kinds of weather. We'll work together as a team till we've perfected a dance routine. The Big Apple, the Big Apple. Just do the Big Apple, do the Big Apple, do the Big Apple. Ride with me. Molly, you aren't so bad yourself.
Oh, never washed my face either. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, Molly. Oh.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Ed. I overslept.
I'd have loved to have the dreams you must have had.
What?
Denise? In a wedding gown? Now there's something that deserves a six-way mirror.
Mirror?
Try to picture it. Six of Denise.
Frankly, that's set up for two of her, one for the both of us. But I guess the best man won. Congratulations.
Thanks.
You know, you didn't know this, neither did Denise, but I was planning on asking her to marry me.
The way you're always clowning around, making with the jokes.
That's how I made my living, remember?
I had no idea you were that serious about her.
You know, come to think of it, I had no idea you were that serious about the lady.
Well, there we were in the House of Mirrors.
Coney Island.
Now, the Carnival in Central Park. There we were, all that shiny glass, those queer shapes, lights just began to pop in my head.
Like skyrockets going off, huh? I'll bet that was romantic.
Yeah, I felt like a different person when we came out of that place. Now I know there was something different about me.
Well, sure. I mean, you're engaged to one of the most exciting, desirable women in New York.
Look,
to show you there's no hard feelings, I'll be your best man. All right. I'm gonna run down to the deli and pick up some bagels. You take it easy. You don't look in any condition for this meeting. Hey, Johnny, the network president's sitting in on it, remember?
Now, let's see. Now I'll take care of you. Wait a minute, there's something familiar about you. Yes, you do look familiar.
I do.
Yes, you're the girl at the checkout counter at the supermarket. The waitress on that restaurant on Madison and 40th?
Don't strain your brain, Mr. Barnes. You're a chicken, you know that?
I'd rather be a chicken than a dead duck. How else would I explain your reflection where mine should be?
Maybe Denise can help you figure it out.
And maybe I'd be the only one who sees it. Maybe I'm going nuts. They'd take me to the nearest funny farm, you know. For the time being, I'm going to keep you under wraps, Missy.
That's not my name.
What is it?
If you don't know, you don't deserve to be told. Hey, I'm suffocating.
Hey there. Oh, hey, good to see our network president, Mr. Thompson.
Good morning.
Yes, it's good to see you too, Johnny, since the latest Nielsen ratings were the highest yet.
We were pleased with the ratings too, but not surprised.
Mr. Lee is never surprised, he knows.
After a while, you get to know when you have a winning combination.
Well, I hired the best producer in the business.
Why, thanks, Sophie.
He's absolutely right, Mr. Lee.
And the best story editor, too.
Emily is good as the material I get. He gives me the best.
Well, we couldn't do it without Ed.
Oh, you couldn't do well without me.
You're just talking about how you're a sensation, Ed.
You know how I love to hear from my fans.
This is show business.
It's just show business. Speaking of show business, I've got tickets for 42nd Street, and I'm going to take all of you tonight.
A Broadway show? Well, I can hardly wait.
Since Mr. Thompson can't wait, why don't you show him the opening number of your next show, Ed?
Yes, and I've got a costume to have some fans anyway.
It's not a bad idea. Frank, will you help out?
If you want me to.
Mr. Thompson, you can't pass down this opportunity.
Oh, no, no, I wouldn't know what to do. Okay, you talk me into it.
Hello, Broadway. sing for you today. Hats off to showbiz, a salute will pay. Glittering light, get our attention, holds us in a spell till the curtain goes up. For all the hours of entertainment, we'll toast to you with our cup. Hello, Broadway, we'll clap for you today. Shout hallelujah, Broadway, that's all we've got to say. Hours and hours of regular backs helps make a show as a matter of fact. For all the hours of entertainment, we'll make it fun to come back. And say, Broadway, you're awful nice to see. Stepping out for an evening, you're the place to be. Taxi uptown to 42nd Street, mingle with the crowds that are on the go. For hours and hours of entertainment, let's all go to the show. For hours and hours of entertainment, let's all go to the show.
That was quite entertaining.
I do my best.
Of course. Hey, Johnny, you know that scream wasn't there when I left.
Oh, yeah, that, you know, when you left earlier, you slammed the door so hard you broke my mirror.
Really? Oh, boy, I guess I don't know my own strength, huh, buddy? Sorry, I'll pay for the damages.
Yeah, forget about it. Let's get down to work here. That's what we're here for, isn't it?
That's right, darling. Linda, let's take us along with the food. This time, try not to be so careless.
Yes, Miss Morgan.
And Peggy, why haven't you handed out the scripts? Do you have to be told everything?
Yes, Miss Morgan.
Listen, everyone. Johnny's got the most marvelous idea for our next show.
Well, I'm anxious to hear it, and so am I.
I had a good idea.
The one you told me about last night.
I don't remember.
Of course you do.
Well, if I did, it's gone completely out of my head.
Don't worry. It'll come back to him. Johnny's not with it as much as usual this morning, but I think that I can explain. You see, we weren't going to make it official yet, but under the circumstances. You see, Johnny's head's a bit in the clouds this morning because we got engaged last night.
To each other.
Well,
congratulations, jerk.
We understand, Johnny. Nobody expects you to be on the ball this morning. I know. Let's all cancel this meeting and go out to lunch for a big celebration. My treat.
How generous of you, Mr. Thompson. You two can go back to the office. There's plenty of work for you to do there.
Now, let's see. Where is there a good restaurant for the occasion?
I suggest the Mirror Room at the Grand Hotel.
A perfect suggestion, Mr. Lee.
Call and make reservations for 6, Miss Wilson.
Yes, sir. Mr. Thompson, if you'll be in town tomorrow.
Oh, I'll be in town for the rest of the week.
Great, we can reschedule for another
fine,
morning then.
Fine.
Yes, is this the Mirror Room? I'd like to make a reservation for...
Whoa, not there, not the Mirror Room.
Johnny, what's the matter with you?
You know, I can understand if you're paying for it.
I've only been there once myself.
I've never been there and I refuse to go now.
You refuse?
I hear the food is rotten.
That's ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
Listen, I happen to know the owner personally.
I don't care if you know the chef personally. I'm not eating in any Mirror Room.
Johnny, what's the matter with you? Mr. Thompson, there are other good restaurants.
I like the Mirror Room.
Then go yourself. You can all go without me.
Maybe it would be better if you all did go without us. I don't think Johnny's feeling very well.
I feel ill.
Okay, fine, whatever. Come on, Frank, we're out of here.
Yes, LT.
But the reservations.
Mr. Thompson doesn't really need reservations.
Denise? Johnny, is there anything I can do?
Just leave me alone with him, Ed. And Peggy, don't forget the scripts.
Yes, Miss Morgan. Ugh, this is a nightmare.
I'm sorry you're not feeling well, Mr. Barnes.
Yeah, thanks, Polly.
Peggy? Oh, what's the difference? Well, if that little exhibition didn't lose our jobs, I don't know what will.
I couldn't help myself.
Couldn't help what? Accepting a generous invitation in our honor?
Anywhere else but there.
You said you'd never been there.
It's called the Mirror Room, isn't it?
Yes.
Then it's probably lousy with mirrors.
All shapes and sizes, tinted and marbleized. There's even a huge one imported from the Palace of Versailles.
That's what I was afraid of.
Johnny, what's the matter with you?
Denise, darling, I love you because you've always been very understanding of me.
I'm finding that a little bit difficult today. But I'll try.
What if I told you I see, or I imagine I see, another girl's reflection when I look in the mirror?
You what?
I can't help it. I do. She even talks back to me.
What girl?
I don't even know what girl. I don't even know her name.
You're not making any sense.
Believe me, Denise, none of this makes sense. But this morning when I looked in the mirror, there she was, talking to me.
A strange girl's face.
Well, not exactly strange. She kind of looked familiar, but I really don't remember.
Oh, I see.
Do you, Denise? Then explain it to me.
She's there, rooted in your subconscious. Someone you knew and loved before.
Oh, come off it, Denise. You back on that psychiatry kick thing again? I bet you gave that up the last time you went to that head shrinker.
I learned a lot in those sessions, enough certainly to know what's going on with you.
Well, you're not doing a very good job of explaining it to me.
A girl you only half remember, and now you see her every time you look in the mirror.
Denise!
It all ties in. It's a complete rejection of me. You proposed to me in front of a mirror, and now you see her face in all of them.
Denise, what you're saying doesn't make any sense.
It does to me. Let me go, bigamist.
Denise, come back here. Don't leave me alone with her.
Hey, you won't believe it. Remember that fortune teller at the carnival? Well, she saw a tall, handsome, red-haired young man in my future. Well, tonight, I met him on that blind date I didn't want to go on. What's the matter? You look scared.
I thought you might be Jonathan Barnes.
That's wishful thinking, isn't it?
Oh, he'll be here all right if he remembers me. And somehow, he'll find a way to put things straight again. But if he doesn't remember me, he'll have to learn to live with it. It will serve him right for treating me like a piece of furniture if he trips over.
You're talking gibberish.
Linda, I know you'll find this difficult to accept. I did myself at first.
I'm listening.
You were asleep when I got back from the carnival, so I undressed in the dark. I didn't discover it till this morning. I didn't tell you then because I thought it was only wishful thinking. Or that somehow the law of relativity or gravity or whatever it is that controls things like this would unscramble everything and make life normal again.
You're still talking gibberish.
It's not gibberish. It's true. Last night I was standing behind Jonathan Barnes in all those tricky mirrors. Suddenly I felt dizzy.
You're dizzy over him. He's a lost cause. You know he's going to marry Miss Morgan.
If he does, all three of us will live unhappily ever after.
The three of you?
Johnny, Miss Morgan, and my reflection in his mirror.
What?
You see, I've got his, and I've no intention of giving it back, if that's the only way I can have him.
I'm going to call a doctor.
See for yourself.
Boggles.
So did mine at first. I'm getting used to it. I even like it. But there are some disadvantages. Combing my hair without seeing myself, putting on makeup.
Does this have to be kept a secret?
I wasn't planning on calling the newspapers.
Can I just tell Heidi and Beth they just got back from their vacation on the Mexican Riviera?
I don't know.
Please, we'll swear them to secrecy.
Okay.
I'm dying to see their faces.
Since things are the way they are, why can't you adjust? I'm doing my best.
Is she telling us the truth?
Let's see it, Peg.
Just stand behind me.
Oh, he's cute.
Hey, that fiery look in his eyes.
I can see why you've got a crush on him.
Oh, I've got more than a crush on him, girls. I've got his reflection, and I intend to keep it.
I guess he has a nice smile.
He's just adorable.
Imagine winning something like him in a carnival.
And you two didn't believe me.
So, Peg, you suppose that if we went to the House of Mirrors, we might get one like him, too?
He looks everywhere for ours, even on the Mexican Riviera.
I'm with you.
Gee,
Senoritas, looking for our senor. We've searched the village over, looking for the one we'll adore. Short ones, tall ones, big ones, small ones, we've looked everywhere. But the man of our dreams was nowhere to be found, it seems. We are three senoritas looking for our senor. One who will be so happy when we do the household chores. We will cook, we will clean, we will love him tenderly. But the man of our dreams was nowhere to be found, it seems. We are three senoritas, you are our senor. We've searched the village over, knocking on every door. To our surprise, we got quiet and opened up our eyes. And the man of our dreams was under our nose, it seemed.
Hallucinations. I only imagined that all of it, nothing like that could really happen, because I didn't have a logical explanation why it could, because things like that just don't happen. That's why it didn't happen. Let's see, where's my dictionary? That'll have some answers, I hope. Let's see, reflection. The state of being reflected. Well, duh, let's see. Reflect. To give back likeness of the image in front of, to become mirrored. Alright. Go on, idiot. Push it away. Why don't I push it away? A chicken, she said so. She, there's no she, just me, my mirror, my reflection. Alright, get on the phone, call Denise, the network president, mend some fences. Why don't I push it away? Yeah, let's just.
Good morning, nice seeing you again.
My juice wasn't poisoned. I must be dead.
That was a very interesting story conference yesterday.
Glad you thought so.
Telling the prize he slammed the door and broke the mirror. Very inventive of you.
Yeah, well, he's not very bright. So when are we going to break this spell and be done with it?
You're not being a very good host. I am your guest, temporarily at least.
How long is temporarily?
It's up to you.
I mean, it's up to me. Hello.
Johnny, it's Denise.
Oh, Denise.
Oh, her.
Denise, I can't talk now. I'm all tied up.
You're all tied up? Well, isn't that sad? I swallowed my pride and called you to give you a chance to explain and...
Look, I can't explain anything. Not yet.
You were telling me who that girl was, that figment that's responsible for you making such a fool of yourself.
She isn't a figment.
Johnny, I'm trying very hard not to lose my temper.
Did she just call me a figment? She's got nerve.
Be quiet.
Did you tell me to be quiet?
I wasn't talking to you.
Who's there with you?
Nobody.
Then who are you talking to?
The girl in the mirror.
Ugh.
Denise? Hello? Hello? Well, I hope you're satisfied.
Is she mad at you again?
Even more so than before.
Then I am satisfied.
Tell me something.
I won't tell you my name or where I belong if that's what you want.
So just tell me why you hate me.
To tell the truth, I am rather fond of you.
Well, because of you, I've probably lost the woman I love as well as my job.
I was standing behind the screen I heard Mr. Thompson say how pleased he was with the reading. I wouldn't worry about losing my job if I were you. As for Denise Morgan, I simply don't know what you see in her.
I don't want to talk about it.
You're hostile.
You bet I am.
Hostility is extremely bad for blood pressure.
I'm not even talking to you anymore. At least I don't intend to. That towel over the bathroom mirror, that's staying put.
Is that why you telephoned the maid and told her not to come in for a few days?
Yes.
What makes you so sure we'll have a solution to our problem in a few days?
Aha! At least we're getting somewhere. You admit that you're a problem.
Why deny it? Did you have any trouble shaving this morning?
No, not at all. Not in the least. Sorry to disappoint you. Cut yourself shaving, huh? You look as if you went 12 rounds with the world's heavyweight champ.
It's just an old blade. It's not as bad as it looks.
But Mr. Barnes, your apartment's never looked so bad, if you'll forgive me for saying so.
Really? I didn't think it was that bad, but if you say so, you know that woman who cleans for me, Molly, she called and sit today.
Oh, well, why don't I pick up a bit?
Good thinking, Miss Wilson. I have a few things to say to Mr. Barnes.
Look, I know what you're going to say, Frank.
Johnny, I've been producer of the Ed Price Show for a long time now, and our relationship up until yesterday has always been smooth and pleasant.
Look, about yesterday, Frank.
Look, what got into you? I'd like an explanation.
Haven't you ever had just an off day?
You weren't just off. You were way out.
Yeah, you know, I think I'm coming down with that jungle virus from Central America.
What jungle virus?
You haven't heard about it?
No.
Well, it's all in the papers, TV, radio. Health department's afraid of a possible epidemic.
Of jungle virus.
Yeah. You know, it starts in the pollen of the wild tiger lily and picked up and carried by the spotted tsetse fly.
Is it contagious?
Scientists aren't sure.
What are the symptoms?
Well, you saw me yesterday. Irrational behavior, inability to think clearly, high fever. You know, I'm beginning to feel feverish now.
Funny I haven't heard about this.
Oh, it only lasts for a couple of days, 3 days at the most, I hope. Why don't I get in touch with you, Frank?
Good idea.
Are we leaving?
The sooner the better.
Don't call me, I'll call you.
Fine, fine. Take care of yourself, Johnny, and give us a great show. I have faith in you.
Thanks, Frank. That's what I need right now. Faith, patience, and some understanding.
You poor boy, you can count on me.
Yeah. Oh, I wouldn't want you to leave on my account.
You sure you want to go in there, Ed?
What do you mean, am I sure? I want to see my best buddy.
I wouldn't get too close to him if I were you.
What's with them? You know not to trust anything a TV producer says.
Yeah, and you should know better than to shave without looking into a mirror.
What made you think I did?
Come on, that couldn't have happened any other way.
Well, the blade was old, so...
It must have been rusty too, huh?
Yeah, well, what do you want, Ed?
Okay, for openers. Well, you must know. I got to thinking after I took Denise home last night.
Did she mention anything about a mirror?
Not that I can remember, why?
Never mind.
Anyways, I got to thinking after I took her home. I had slammed that front door hard enough to break a heavy thing like that.
Well, you did. You said so yourself. You didn't know your own strength.
I can see the screen still in front of it.
You've got 20/20 vision.
And you're hostile this morning.
I'm not hostile. I wish everybody would stop saying that I am.
Is that what Frank Lee called you?
Yeah, it was just Frank, nobody else.
I guess that's why you didn't want me to come in.
I guess so.
Look, Johnny. We've been friends for a long time. Old pals, you know?
Look, Ed, I know you want to help, but if everybody would just get off my back for a couple of days, it'll all work itself out.
What's going to happen in a couple of days?
Well, for one thing, I'll finish the script I've been working on. You know, I'm getting the feeling I'm losing my touch.
I don't believe it.
Believe it? That's why I was so edgy yesterday and hostile today. I've been up since the crack of dawn. The wastebasket's full of false starts.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't look to me as if you've been working.
Well, Miss Wilson was kind enough to clean up most of the mess.
You know, half the time I believe you, half the time I don't. You really confuse me sometimes.
Look, and if you're the true blue pal that you say that you are, you'll believe me when I say I'm in a rut right now. Let me get myself out of it.
There's nothing I can do.
Not right now. Just let me alone. What are you doing?
I want to see how much damage I did.
It's in smithereens.
Really? And all I did was close the door?
Go on, Ed, I want to get some work done.
Oh, no, at least I gotta see.
Can't you take a hint?
Okay, I'm going.
Now!
You've gone crazy.
I said now, Ed.
You know, I feel sorry for Denise. She's planning to marry a nut.
All right, if everybody just give me a chance to think. I'm a smart guy. I'll figure out something here, little lady.
Think of something. That's Ed again.
Ed just ran past us. What's the hurry? Oh, Johnny, what happened to your face?
I cut myself shaving because I was groggy.
You see, Mr. Thompson?
Yes, Denise, you are quite right.
What's this all about?
Oh, your fiancé explained everything.
She couldn't possibly.
Oh, she came to see me. She told me how hard you've been working.
You've seen the results of his work, Mr. Thompson. Number one on Nielsen's rating.
Johnny, I'm afraid I've been a bit too hasty yesterday. I apologize.
Look, Mr. Thompson, I'm the one that should apologize. My behavior yesterday was...
Was the result of overwork. It's as simple as that.
Wow, you make it sound so simple.
Well, I don't want my best friend to come down with a nervous breakdown.
You know, since yesterday I felt like I was coming down with one.
Just wait till you hear what this generous man's going to do, Johnny.
Oh, yes. Johnny, in my opinion, you need a long rest.
You can say that again.
You need a long rest.
Right.
Listen, Johnny. The next show has already been taped, and we're already putting final touches on the one after that. Why don't you and Denise go ahead and get married right away?
Right away?
How does Hawaii strike you? The network will foot all the bills. Consider it a wedding present. Oh, and I brought some champagne for you to take along with you on your trip.
Wow, thank you, sir.
Isn't it wonderful, darling? We're going to be married much earlier than we planned.
What was that?
That's some bad plumbing. I complained to the landlord about it. Look, Mr. Thompson, I don't know how to thank you for all your generosity. This is just wonderful.
It's insurance for better television ratings in the future. Oh, Denise, my limousine and chauffeur are waiting right outside. Shall I have them give you a lift to the back of the office?
That's okay. I'll pick up my own taxi in a while.
Of course. You two young people want to discuss your honeymoon. Johnny, you're looking much better.
I feel much better. Thanks again, Mr. Thompson.
Catch you later.
What are you doing? I told you that's smashed.
When are you going to get it fixed?
One of these days, it'll be fixed. Besides, your hair is beautiful. You're beautiful.
Isn't it wonderful, darling? It all happened so fast.
You're right about that.
Dream honeymoon, all expenses paid. There's just one problem if we get married.
What's that?
Is there anything over the mirror in the bathroom?
Not exactly over, just in front of. There's a towel.
See this girl? She may be imaginary, but she's coming between us.
I almost forgot all about her.
That's why I asked Dr. Farber to come and see you.
Isn't Dr. Farber the...
Brilliant analyst who changed me from the shrieking violet I was underneath, who made it possible for me to accept that I am better than practically everyone else. Clever, more attractive.
You're simply not that shrinking violet today, Denise.
Then you'll see her?
It won't do me any good. Her?
Didn't I ever mention that Dr. Farber was a woman? She overcame her early insecurities, too. You find she has a penetrating insight. She absolutely inspires confidence. She
won't do me any good.
I'll believe that when I hear from her. And if she can't help you, I'll have to find someone or someplace that can.
What's that supposed to mean?
There are places, Johnny, for people who see other people rather than themselves when they look in the mirror. Please try to cooperate with Dr. Farber. Do it for me. Oh, tell her I couldn't say it.
What,
say hello for me.
She's coming now?
She should be here any minute. I'll be in touch with you later, darling.
Well, now I'm in for it.
How nice to see the world again. How nice to see you again.
Naturally, you heard all that.
Naturally. Are you sure you want to marry her?
Yes. Do you realize what's going to happen, though, when that psychiatrist gets here? She'll start asking me all kinds of questions. I know how these characters operate. She'll draw it out of me little by little. And next thing you know, I'll explain how I... misplaced my reflection in the house of mirrors and brought yours home instead. Next thing you know, she'll get on the phone, and then a couple minutes later, two guys in white jackets will come with a special jacket for me.
I'm going to enjoy that.
I thought you said you were fond of me.
The screen.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to blow it too soon, I guess. Oh, Dr. Farber, I believe.
Mr. Barnes, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yes, Denise said to expect you.
She wanted me to expect some resistance on your part.
Does it look as though I'm resisting? So what do we do now? I lay there, you sit down? I'm rather new at this.
Would you be more comfortable lying down?
Yeah, frankly, it's been a rough day today, and yesterday was even rougher.
Now, Mr. Barnes, do tell me about yourself.
You mean Denise hasn't already filled you in?
I'd rather hear it from you firsthand.
Well... this morning, when I looked in the mirror, there she was. I hope you can help me, Doc.
Well, I'll try. Go on.
Well, she's in the mirror in the bathroom over the sink, and she's in that mirror behind you.
I understand completely.
Wow. So fast. Denise was right. You are brilliant.
True, true, true. It was not an immodest statement. It was merely an expression of self-awareness.
Please, don't apologize. Continue with what you were saying. Do you understand what completely?
Mr. Barnes, in reality, you are running away from yourself.
You don't understand. It's this girl I'm running away from.
Well, Mr. Barnes, you should start by removing that screen from in front of your mirror.
Weren't you listening to a thing I just said?
This is a very interesting case. The initial stages of dementia praecox, manifesting itself in this particular paranoid type of delusions.
Whatever you say, you sure you want me to?
Mr. Barnes, with me here to reassure you, you will not only have the courage to take away that screen, but you will discover now that you know it's all in your mind, that only your own reflection will be looking back at you.
Whatever you say, Doc.
How do you spell dementia praecox?
Some imagination we've got. Isn't that right, Doc?
There's a psychiatric convention in Atlantic City. I hadn't planned on going. I may need help. I know I need help.
I told you there was something to worry about. Not from her, anyway.
Did you see the look on her face? I kind of felt sorry for her.
There's nothing really wrong with you. You don't need a psychiatrist. We both know it.
So tell me, when are we going to be done with this?
Me? I could go on like this forever.
We leave each morning about 8:30. We hurry to the station so as not to be late. And board the train marked 105. The cars are crowded and not too wide. We hope to sit for the 20-block ride as the rhythm of the train goes from side to side. The Subway Express. The Subway Express. It's the train we take to get to work each day. It's the Subway Express. We glance around just to see who's there. Any single man to meet if we dare. At each stop there's a whole new group as the subway crowd rides the loop. Out of watching miles of strain, no one for us on any train. The Subway Express. The Subway Express. It's the train we take to get to work each day. It's the Subway Express. Wouldn't it be nice if one fine day we'd be there to meet, smile and say, thank you for your seat, sir, how kind you are. You don't mind standing, you're not going very far. At first glance, it'd be love at first sight as the subway train goes on to tonight. The Subway Express. The Subway Express. It's the train we take to get to work each day. It's the Subway Express.
I'll come out. We won't hurt you.
Oh, we just want to be friendly.
Put it down. If Peggy comes in, she's going to be mad. It belongs to her. She's so lucky, isn't she?
I wish I had one like him.
Yeah, so do I. Of course, the relationship would be sort of limiting, to be perfectly honest.
Just the same. I cannot believe we're looking at my own face in the mirror.
What's going on?
We just wanted to see your little friend.
He isn't being very sociable.
He won't come out. We haven't even had a peek at him.
Where are your brains? He's taking the place of my reflection, remember?
So no one can see him, unless you're here.
That's right.
Oh, please, Peg. I'm out of the mood. Maybe later.
Oh, come on. Be a sport, just for a minute.
Well, all right. Stand behind me.
There he is.
With us instead of you.
Hey there.
Got a friend for me. I don't think he's in the mood. And if you girls will excuse me, neither am I. I don't feel so hot.
Sorry, Peg. She doesn't look so hot, does she?
What's wrong now?
It was after you left the office, so you didn't hear about it.
What happened?
It's what's going to happen. As soon as the latest script is wrapped up, they're going to be married and go off on their honeymoon.
My Johnny and her. I don't care what you see in that mirror. He never was your Johnny. Face it, it's time.
They're going to Hawaii, a dream honeymoon.
Well, aren't you lucky?
Me?
Correct me if I'm misquoting. If he marries her, the three of us will live unhappily ever after. Johnny, Miss Morgan, and my reflection in his mirror.
Please, Linda.
Weren't those your exact words?
My reflection going with them on their honeymoon?
What a gruesome thought. How are you going to stop it?
I should stop it long ago, right after it happened.
Finally, we agree on something.
I kept hoping.
I'm curious to know what you did hope to get out of this besides the big headache you have now.
In my imagination, I could see him looking in the mirror at my reflection and suddenly remembering who I was. Peggy, I'd imagined he'd say.
He usually calls you Polly.
So, it's you, Peggy. Why haven't I really noticed you before? But now that I have, we've got to get to know each other a lot better.
You've got some imagination.
Obviously, it hasn't happened, Linda. I've accepted the fact that he doesn't even know I'm alive. But tomorrow he will, and then he'll probably kill me. When I think of what that poor guy has gone through because of me,
how are you going to put an end to it? How can he?
He's so clever. He'll think of something. At the story conference, I'll find a way to take him aside, make him look directly at me, and after that...
You're right. He may kill you.
It's obvious, so obvious, together we belong. Just open your eyes and you'll realize together is our song.
What am I thinking about? Oh, I must stay calm. And reflection, please, be gone. It's impossible, just impossible. Us together? Ah, it's all wrong.
It's a time for sharing a moment or two. It's time to be a new friend. It's time for learning more about you. Time for our lives to blend.
It's impossible, just impossible. I'm engaged to someone else, but familiar she seems in a pleasant way, and her eyes, how they sparkle to please.
The feelings I had seems to swell within. How much longer must it be? It's obvious, so obvious. Together we belong.
It's impossible. Us together, it's all wrong.
You called me, Mr. Barnes. You said you were too busy working to be interrupted.
Mm.
But now what's wrong with you and me, Catherine? But I know the bachelor's all the neatest people, if you forgive me for saying.
Can you say something, Molly?
Now, doesn't your apartment look a wee bit better now that I've gone over it?
Yeah, much better.
The amount of dust that collects in a big city. In just a couple of days, we'll have done the kitchen and the bathroom.
Swell.
Did you know you had a towel over the mirror in the sink in the bathroom? Why didn't you put it there?
Oh, that, you know, it was easier to hang it back there than to put it back on the towel rack.
Oh, isn't that just like a bachelor? Well, things will be changing when you and Miss Morgan are married. Is it eight sentient?
You know, we're going off to our honeymoon to Hawaii as soon as everything can be arranged.
Hawaii, how exciting! Wow, that's pretty far away now, isn't it?
It is. You know, you have to cross the water to get there.
I know!
Did you know that ghosts can't cross water?
Can't say they have.
It's a theory.
Oh, I don't believe in ghosts.
Well, there's a lot of things I didn't used to believe in, but right now, I am kind of in water to do a job for me. Thanks for coming in, Molly. The place really looks much better than the meeting this morning.
Well, it would look better without that screen. How did you say Mr. Price broke it?
He slammed the door too hard.
Imagine that. Well, when are you going to get it fixed?
One of these days, it'll be fixed.
I'm done here. I'll keep that on your way out.
Thanks, Molly.
Hello.
Hey, I just finished up some changes here on the script. I think you will all be pleased, especially you, Mr. Thompson.
Oh, I'm pleased already, Johnny. And you're looking much more yourself.
I feel much my own self. You know, last night I woke up and I remembered that ghosts can't cross water. What was that?
What did you say?
Oh, it's just another idea I'm working on for the next script. I'll finish it when I get back from my honeymoon with Denise.
Now, Johnny, forget about work while you're gone. Just put the show on your mind and enjoy your honeymoon with Denise.
Thanks, sir.
I'll get that. Good morning, everyone. Am I late?
No, we just barely arrived ourselves.
Good morning, Denise.
Good morning, Johnny. You look much more like your old self.
I feel much my old self.
There's Dr. Barbara. I'm trying to get a hold of her, but she doesn't seem to answer her phone.
Let's talk about it later.
Okay, you two lovebirds, not during working hours.
Sorry, Mr. Thompson.
Johnny's been polishing his script. He's sure you'll like it.
Well, that's what I like. Confidence. Where's Ed?
He should be here any minute.
Yeah, you know, there's a tricky crap ball I've written in one of these scenes. I want to make sure he can do it.
That's probably Ed now.
Let's let him in and start passing out the drinks.
Yes, Miss Morgan.
Good morning, Linda.
Good morning, Mr. Price.
Sorry I'm late, gang. I got caught in traffic. Did I miss much?
No, we were just getting started.
Oh, good.
Thank you. I haven't handed out those scripts yet.
Sorry, Miss Morgan.
Do it now.
Yes, Miss Morgan.
I have no copy, Polly. I mean, Peggy.
Yes, Mr. Barnes.
Okay, we're all agreed through page 8, correct? So let's turn over to page 9.
You mean the beginning of the second scene?
Right. And that's all we're going to do to ourselves, and afterwards we'll talk about a few changes I have in mind.
How am I going to take him aside?
I don't know.
I'm so nervous.
Just take it easy. Girls, what's that taking so long with the food?
Here's a tray. Don't drop it.
I'll do my best.
Girls! Shaky.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me.
Oh, the clumsy.
Are you okay, sir?
Yeah, I'm fine.
That stupid girl.
I'm sure it was just an accident.
Yeah, just an accident.
But I'm afraid she ruined your tiny shirt.
The studio will replace both naturally.
Naturally?
Yes. Miss Wilson, is that the bathroom over there? If I could just get some cold water. Stain on me.
You should be fired for this.
I'm sure that girl didn't do it deliberately. Don't be so hard on her. I'm going to go check out Mr. Thompson.
How can you have been so clumsy?
She's upset this morning.
You certainly upset the meeting, Peggy.
Don't worry, John. The thing's coming out.
I hope so, Mr. Thompson.
Peggy, what are you doing back here?
Peggy, what? Peggy?
You can get that close to Green. She was just right behind me, in the bathroom here.
What? It is you!
I've been trying to tell you since I got here, Mr. Barnes.
I couldn't seem to get you alone.
Wait a second, what's going on? What's this all about?
I don't get it. Neither do I.
Neither do I.
That was so strange. I distinctly saw her reflection in the bathroom mirror.
Come on, you've got some business to take care of.
Please let me explain.
You can explain in the taxi.
Johnny, where are you taking her?
To the park.
What park?
Central.
Johnny, I demand you come back here. What do you mean you're taking her to the park? Johnny!
Poor Peggy.
Poor Johnny.
I'm never getting work done.
Well, I hope this place looks familiar to you. I've had nightmares about it.
You haven't even given me a chance to explain.
I'm trying to remain calm. Explain.
I'm beginning to wonder what I ever saw in you.
I'm not sure I really even saw you, at least a three-dimensional you.
Oh, I can tell you this now because it doesn't matter anymore. It's all over.
It won't be over until we go into the house and there's and get this all straightened out.
What's over is my feelings for you.
For me?
Since the first day I went to work at the office, you came in to deliver a script. You were wearing a tan suit with a green and black striped shirt and a pink tie. You haven't a very good color sense, you know.
You didn't happen to notice my socks.
Mismatched. One brown, the other black. With all those colors, I don't think anyone noticed. Are you colorblind by any chance?
Lately, the only color I've been seeing is white. So you've developed an interest in me because of my lousy sense of color?
Oh, I overlooked that, just as you overlooked me whenever we were in the same room together. Other people have feelings, too. Even lowly secretarial assistants are human.
Look, if I hurt your feelings, I'm sorry.
It's a little embarrassing for me to say all this.
I want to hear it!
You're young again.
I would appreciate hearing whatever it is you have to say.
Sometimes I even followed you around. Once I sat across from you in a diner. I was hoping you'd notice me and ask if you could join me, since we were both eating alone. You didn't even glance my direction. And at story conferences.
Were you really at all of them?
Every one, for the last 3 months.
Look, I apologize if I was rude ignoring you the way I did, but you must have realized I was pretty well occupied with the script. Why am I apologizing?
Think of it this way. It could have been someone else standing behind you in all those mirrors. Someone on the next plane to Nairobi or Madagascar? Then where would you be? You're lucky you found me.
I'll be even luckier when I lose you. Come on, let's go get this taken care of. Hey, where's everybody at?
I'm here.
Then it's just the two of us?
That's right.
Well, who needs more than two on a honeymoon?
We're not on our honeymoon, Johnny, and at this point, I'm not sure we ever will be.
I get the feeling you're a tiny bit upset.
Tiny?
Look, I got these for you. I wish they were diamonds, but maybe I could arrange that, too. I suddenly realized I never got you an engagement ring. I hope you like this, Denise, dear.
Don't dear me, Johnny. When did it occur to you? When you were skipping barefoot in the park with my secretary?
Stop letting your imagination run away with you.
Okay, alright. I'm a reasonable person. I'm willing to listen to any explanation you may have.
You don't want my flowers?
Oh, did you have Peggy pick them in the rose garden? How romantic.
Peggy? She doesn't mean anything to me.
Of course not. That's why you suddenly grabbed her and rushed her out of here, as the thought of not being alone with her for one moment more was more than you could bear.
Denise, if you only knew how ridiculous that sounds. And I didn't pick them with her in the park or anything. I bought them by myself, alone. Aren't you interested in at least seeing the ring?
I'm interested in hearing your explanation. Is it as wild as the last one? Are you still seeing girls' faces in your mirror?
No, that's all over. The only person I'm seeing is me now. See? Just me. You know, I'm not bad looking.
When did you get that fixed?
Today.
Before we got here, you mean?
I'd have to mean that, wouldn't I?
Can you watch the screen in front of it?
Habit. I got used to seeing it there, and I just forgot to push it back. Let's forget about the mirror. Let's talk about us.
Let's talk about you and Peggy.
Well, I suddenly realized I needed to get you an engagement ring, so I thought she could help me pick out a beautiful one.
What made you think that dull-witted girl could help pick out a beautiful one?
Well, she's a girl, and she's a lot less dull-witted than you give her credit for. But I soon realized I didn't need her help, so I sent her back to the studio, and I went and picked one out by myself. Aren't you interested in at least seeing it? Look, you know, Denise, I'll be the same dependable Johnny when we get back from our honeymoon.
I wish I could believe that.
Believe it.
There are still some things I don't understand, but for once, I'm going to let my heart rule my head. Can you put the ring on my finger?
Thank you, Denise. Hey, remember this?
Mr. Thompson gave it to us to take on our honeymoon.
Why, wait, let's celebrate now.
Wonderful idea.
You know, it should be chilled for so.
I'll go to the kitchen to get a nice and glasses.
Great idea. Well, we talked ourselves out of that one, didn't we? We, gotta get used to not thinking that way. It's not we anymore, it's just me. One of me with matching reflection. Job, I like it. Girl, I love. Okay, come on, idiot. Smile, don't just stand there looking down. I know all about your reflections. There's more to you than meets the eye. So why are you looking all down in the mouth? Cheer up, pal. I understand. You wish you were back in there looking at her instead of me. Can't say I blame you. She is a cute girl. And a lot of fun in a zany kind of way. I hate to admit it, but I miss her too. I miss her. She's not going to be here anymore. All of a sudden, my life seems awfully dull.
You talking to yourself?
Just thinking out loud.
About us?
It's no use, Denise.
What's no use?
Us. It'll never work. I'm simply not worthy of you. You can keep the ring. Can we at least be friends?
Morgan, it's Peggy. I'm calling from the office. I was told to call you at Mr. Barnes' apartment.
Peggy, you're all I need right
Peggy.
Now.
I called to tell you, I just finished cleaning out my desk.
You called to tell me you're cleaning out your desk?
I don't believe this. You don't understand. I'm quitting.
Quitting?
What'd she say?
I'm tired of the city. I want to go home. I come from a small town, population 2819, but I miss it.
You can be replaced very easily, and don't forget that.
I'm sorry about this morning, the drink and everything.
I'm sorry you didn't have the consideration to give me more notice. Well, finish up the work you have there, and then go wherever you please. Now let's get back to us.
Why is Peggy quitting?
She's homesick. What were you saying before she called? Something about not being worthy of me?
You can do better than me, believe me. Where did Peggy say she was from?
She didn't. Johnny, on TV, this is what we call a big confrontation scene. You're deliberately trying to avoid it.
I already have. Weren't you listening? I'm simply not worthy of you. I meant when I said it that you could keep the ring, too.
You're a completely psychotic case. You know that? While you were gone, I contacted Dr. Barber, and she's been putting this sanatorium for a month! After just one session with you! Well, I've had enough. More than enough.
You're absolutely right.
I never should have given up Ed Price. I didn't know that I was well off.
I'll be sure to tell him that the next time I see him. Best of luck to you both. If you see him first, tell him the best man won after all. Well, that went well. So we ought to try and keep these fresh for Peggy. Seems how she wasn't with me when I picked them. Let's see, in the ring, if I were to give this to her, would it be like giving her a secondhand ring? Probably wouldn't matter because she didn't really have it that long for it to be considered secondhand, so we'll not worry about that. Alright, stop wasting time. Let's get on the phone and call Peggy. Milford Studio, Ed Price Show, please.
Ed Price Show?
Peggy.
This is Linda, Mr. Barnes. She isn't here.
Oh, I should have known it wasn't her voice. Where is she? I got a few things to settle with that girl.
She isn't here. You're not going to make trouble for her, are you? Please don't. Just let her go back home.
Where's back home?
Rushville, Illinois, population 2819.
So has she already left?
No, she's on her way to your apartment. Ms. Morgan asked her to finish up her work here first.
She's coming here?
She said something about picking up the script with the changes and delivering it to the printer. She took a taxi. It's not very far. She should be there any minute.
Any minute?
You're not going to make trouble for her, are you? Hello? Hello?
Have I got a girl for you? Peggy. Oh, Ed, I didn't expect you too. Why don't you come back some other time then, old buddy? Hello, Peggy.
I came to get the script, Mr. Barnes.
Just a few changes I need to make. Stick around if you would, please. Ed, you don't need to stay.
The only reason I'm here is because I happen to be at the office, picking up my fan mail. Anyways, I noticed that Peggy was coming down here and felt a little uncomfortable about doing it alone. So I came with her.
And you delivered her safe and sound. Thank you. You can leave now.
Careful, buddy. Boy, you're crowding me.
Peggy and I have got a lot of important things to talk about.
What have we got to talk about, Mr. Barnes?
I'll think of something. How about having dinner with me?
Why? How?
Because I think I'd enjoy it, and I think you would, too. You know, I'm not that hard to get used to once you get to know me.
Look, Johnny, you never paid any attention to any girl until I saw her first. It started off in college, and it kept up until you took Denise away from me. You're looking for a good punch, my friend.
Look, you know, Denise is waiting for you. She said to tell you that she never knew when she was well off.
You know what? Tell him you're leaving here with me.
Tell him the truth. Tell him we've been living together.
What?
Well, I suppose you might say that.
Why, you've been engaged to Denise?
Yeah, it was bigger than the both of us. I couldn't help myself.
Couldn't help yourself?
Oh, damn. Mr. Barnes, are you okay?
Yeah, it's not bad.
Please, look. Peggy, I mean,
let me start all over.
You mean you want to after all the trouble I caused you? You even called me double trouble, remember?
As Dr. Farber would say, I have retrograde amnesia. All I know is I've seen a pretty girl for the first time, in full color and in three dimension. Say, you look very familiar.
Have
we met somewhere before?
It's possible. I have been in some pretty strange and out of the way places lately.
My name is Johnny Barnes.
Mine is Peggy Miller. My, you have a nice, strong hand.
Yours are nice and soft, too. I can feel it. But say, if you're not busy tonight, how about having dinner with me?
I think I'd like that.
I know a really nice place. It's pretty expensive, but who cares? I'm in the mood to celebrate.
The mirror room?
See how well we get along. You read my mind.
All those reflections. It could be fun.
I got you on my mind. It felt so natural, it felt so good to be with you when we were talking today. We talked all about the things that we liked and would like to do someday.
It felt so natural, it felt so good to be with you when we had that little fight. You stood at the corner and talked for a while in the firelight.
I got you. I can't deny it's true, I must admit to you, I got you on my mind. I got you on my mind too.
What are we going to do about this predicament? What are we going to do about how we feel?
There's nothing wrong with this predicament. Simply proves our love is real. It felt so
natural, it felt so good to be with you
when we're together alone. Meant a great deal, so we'd like to make it known. I got you on my mind. I got you,
I got you on my mind.
I must admit to you,
I got you on my mind.
I got you on my mind too.
Another tale just 1 minute more, a knock at the door, and he comes more than a maid.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Tell your people what I'm gonna do, yeah. Get in the mood and let the good time roll. We gonna stay here till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long, yeah. Ooh, it might be one, it might be three. Ooh, time don't mean that much to me. I ain't felt this good since I don't know when. Ooh, I might not feel this good again, yeah. Get in the mood, let the good time roll. We're gonna stay here till we soothe our soul. If it takes all night long. Yeah, all night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
Somebody said
all night
might take all night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
Night, night long.
All night.
Somebody said
all night
might take all night. Yeah. No!